I'm here to talk about what we'll be using for second grade science in the fall. God's design, life for beginners, what we've been doing the human body unit. And now we'll be moving on to mammals. It's the animal unit. For examples. If you really like this book, I highly recommend it. But it's very Christian based, so if you're not a Christian or don't want anything Christian, don't get this, but if you do. Simple, it's easy. You can do little projects to do inside it. There's also, when they have a big vocabulary word to learn, you don't have them write the word, they have them trace the word, which I like. Okay. We're also going to be doing the big book of science. It starts in second grade and goes to third grade, so we'll be tackling this. Different units. We're not just going to be doing animals. We'll be doing all kinds of stuff because we'll be going through this book. We're also going to be doing second grade science. I do this one for 180 days to pass the standardized test for science. I think that's pretty cool. They do these for that and focus on something they love. So they pass the standardized test plus focus on something they love. Here's just an example of some of the books we'll be using because we're doing a lot of encyclopedias and readers this year because my son decided he didn't want to move on to the next book in South by Science, which is biology. He wants to go back and do the human body and zoology again. So we'll move on to book three. But for right now, I'm just doing what he loves. And we got these Wildcat books. We have most of them. Just ordered the two new ones and the little readers, the little science readers. I highly recommend them, and they're very, very educational. So if you are a science lover who's just learning to read, highly recommend the science readers from Step Into Reading. And this is just a sample. We have all the books for this series, except for, I think I'm missing one. But we got weather, science, and animals here just to show you. This is just an example of some of the books. We have all of them. We're going to be using them throughout the year. This is the animal one. Here is the science one. And see, there's a whole bunch. I highly recommend these little first big books by National Geographic Kids. I highly recommend them. This one's about weather. We have a few weather books because I'm really into weather, so I got a few of them because we had a hurricane. It was really cool to have these books to teach my son about the hurricane so he wouldn't be scared by it. We have all the books from this series, the Take Along Nature Guide. We'll be using these. He keeps it up to date. He likes to look at the squirrels and the rodents, so why we have them. And we have the two big heavy ones, the red one and the green one. And then we have the one about space. And one about space says nine planets, not eight planets. It's a little outdated. But the pictures are beautiful, and I highly recommend it, just so you can tell them about science back in your day and what the advances they've made now. I love doing that with my son. This is the book he wants to reread, Zoology. We may reread the anatomy too, but for right now, we're just rereading, in the fall, only plan to reread the zoology. And we got my first encyclopedia of animals to go along with it, the encyclopedia of animals. Let's see what we're going through. And we have God's Big Book of Animals. He really likes this book. I want to get the bug one from Master Books also. It's pretty cool. So this is everything we'll be doing. This is an example of stuff we'll be using in the fall for school. Whatever we do read, I will do a video on it and show you. So have a great day. If you need any help with picking out an encyclopedia or something to do with your kids, please hook me up. I'm willing to help, and I highly recommend SASRS Science. Thank you.